The mysteries of the Dark Ages. Since the dawn of history, Europe has been home to some of the most advanced civilizations in the world. The Minoans, the Greeks, the Romans, the British. But at one point in history, suddenly, out of nowhere, the advancement of the European people stopped dead in its tracks. For centuries, this corner of the world began to regress, with records of this period being incredibly hard to come by. So, what happened? What caused this? Has anyone ever explained the mysteries of the Dark Ages? Number 3. Why did it happen? The Dark Ages originally referred to the period of Western European history between the decline of the Roman Empire and the Renaissance of the 14th century. This was one of the least progressive eras mankind has ever endured, as during this time, Europe suffered barely any economic growth for over a millennium. Living standards failed to improve. The average age of death was no higher than 30, and with constant famines, poor education, and streets littered with sewage, Europe was more primitive than it had been for centuries. There are many reasons why this sudden regression happened, but the two which historians consider the most influential are political instability and religion. In the absence of the Roman Empire, Western Europe became politically fragmented, leading to constant wars and invasions. Trade routes and public infrastructures were ruined. Poor sanitation meant that plagues were a regular occurrence, and organized education was almost non-existent. Most people could barely read or write, and this lack of skills meant that much of the classical knowledge from centuries past was lost, since nobody could either read or understand the writings of our greatest thinkers. Science and philosophy were replaced by spirits and superstition, with hardline religious beliefs taking hold over rational thought, to the detriment of our formerly advanced society. And this is no atheist attack on religion either. This view was espoused by devout individuals, such as the Tuscan scholar Petrarch, who went so far as to describe the non-Christian Greek and Roman eras as a light, compared to the darkness and gloom of the Dark Ages. Whereas the classical civilizations had sought to understand the natural world, investigating such fields as biology, physics, and meteorology, Dark Age society instead focused on getting to know the big guy in the sky. We began to believe that demons caused disease, and that licking leprosy wounds would cure them, that chastity belts were a sound idea, and that women riding a man on top was somehow morally wrong. Europe stopped achieving and started believing, and because of this, we have barely any records from one of the most desperate times in world history. Number 2. The missing manuscripts. With Dark Age Europe mostly consisting of illiterate people scrabbling around for food, trying to hide from the plague, it's no surprise that few records were kept. The medieval production of manuscripts gradually rose as Europe entered the 12th and 13th centuries, mostly thanks to European monasteries whose monks laboriously copied ancient texts to preserve them. But before that, very few historical events or technological advances were written down for posterity. So, what have we missed out on? In terms of historical events, we have lost a great deal of information pertaining to European exploration of the Americas. The famous 15th century Vinland map purportedly shows North America, and we know for certain that the Vikings reached Newfoundland on their travels across the Atlantic Ocean. But did they make it even further? Some evidence suggests a Norse presence as far as Minnesota, but thanks to the Dark Ages, we may never know for sure. The rise and fall of certain leaders has also been poorly documented from this time. Al-Hakim Bi-Amr Allah was ruler of Egypt and much of North Africa during the early 11th century, but according to history, one day he just upped and disappeared. King Edward II also ruled England for nearly two decades in the 14th century, And once more, while we know he was deposed, we have no idea as to his fate. Then there are a few mysteries related to famous artifacts. For example, who created the Shroud of Turin? What was the recipe for Greek fire? And what exactly was the purpose of the mysterious Voynich manuscript? One of the most intriguing mysteries regarding the Dark Ages, which could be solved by these missing records, is the idea that part of it may never have taken place. Specifically, the period between 614 and 911 AD. Phantom time hypothesis is a historical theory proposed by Herbert Illich, who claims a conspiracy between Holy Roman Emperor Otto III, Pope Sylvester II, and Byzantine Emperor Constantine VII resulted in the fabrication of 297 years of history. The purpose of this was to allow the trio to have ruled during the year of 1000 AD. And while this theory isn't widely believed by the historical community, its prevalence just goes to show how many gaps there are in our knowledge of Dark Age history. Number 1. Mother Nature. While the follies of men played a major role in causing the Dark Ages to occur, Mother Nature certainly didn't help matters with her own intervention. The lack of sanitation in Europe is one of the main reasons mass plagues took hold. But such diseases are, of course, a natural occurrence. The Black Death is thought to have originated in China, having spread to Europe via Crimea along the Silk Road. This disease wiped out 20 million people across Europe, and if that hadn't weakened people enough, then the following bouts of famine sure did. Scientists at Cardiff University have identified a comet which struck the Earth at some point around 536 to 540 AD. This comet, which exploded in the upper atmosphere, smothered our planet in ash and dust, causing a medieval-style nuclear winter in the process. The cooler climate caused by this caused mass crop failures and summer frosts in Western Europe 1,500 years ago. And just as its population was recovering, Mother Nature followed up with the Little Ice Age. This event caused global temperatures to drop rapidly, leading to further crop failures and mass starvations. In some places, this mini ice age lasted through to the 19th century. So, if that's the case, and one of the main causes of the Dark Ages persisted until just 200 years ago, then surely the Dark Ages could return again? We're going to investigate this in our bonus video, The Next Dark Age, which you can watch on our Patreon page at patreon.com/strangemysteries. For a $2 a month pledge, which you can cancel at any time, you'll get to watch this and all our bonus content, which goes deeper and darker into every topic than YouTube allows. If you don't want to donate, then that's
bullshit. We know you wanted more. Strange Mysteries on YouTube and our Patreon bonus videos weren't enough to quench your search for truth, to give you that sense of awe and wonder again, to go past what you thought was the end, to give you the answers you seek, but which only lead to more questions. That's why we just upped the stakes. Chemicals of reality. Reality, consciousness, brains. What else is there? Ask yourself that question. Perhaps that's all there really is, but perhaps everything else is found within a place where these ideas, these things, overlap. Some thing, some place that is undefinable. To many people, altering certain chemicals in their brains produces what they would simply call hallucinations. In fact, what we're going to discuss specifically used to be called the businessman's trip, as one could enjoy it. Come down and put your pants back on in the time it takes to eat lunch. It wasn't taken seriously. Well, unless, of course, you started digging. And some people, including us, did. Already, though, to many people, this chemical is special amongst others. Very special. To them, it represents something more meaningful and incredible, as if it's the gateway to the next level of consciousness. The ticket to a higher reality barely explored by most humans. It is the entry point to a new reality visited by only a select few whose minds have become enlightened through the use of this exotic substance. For this reason, it's commonly referred to as the spirit molecule. But is its reputation as a mystical mind opener deserved? Or is it and everything it represents just a load of bullshit? We look at, investigate, and dive deeply into nearly all available research regarding this question from nearly every angle feasible. And in the course of doing so, stumble upon unexplainable patterns, correlations, and neurological evidence for a reality existing beyond this one. Watch this hour-long Strange Mysteries premium video, Chemicals of Reality, as well as many more to come by becoming an elite premium member of our Patreon at patreon.com/strangemysteries.